Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Trouble Free. In today's video I'm going to tell you about my own interview experience of Infosys. I'm done with my interview today itself, so in this video I'm going to tell you what are the questions that I faced and what was the duration of the interview, what was the behavior of the interview, like how comfortable the interviewer made me to feel, and all those things I'm going to tell you in this video. So let's get started. First, I'll tell you the date, time and all about the exam, interview. The date was on 24th of April 2021. Actually, I've given the exam in December. So, almost it took 4 months, 4 to 5 months we can say. So, don't worry. If you're not getting your interview schedule yet, don't worry, you'll be getting. They'll take some time. So, and the time which I was given was 12:42 to 12:59. That is about 19 minutes. And the platform is Cisco WebEx. In Cisco WebEx platform, you'll be having your interview. And the role is system engineer. Since Infosys is hiring for different roles like SES and Power Programmer and all, so that's why I want to clearly mention that the role was system engineer. And if you're confused about for which role you have written your exam, if you have written your exam on InfiniQ platform, which was for around 100 minutes, then you have written your exam for software system engineer role itself. Okay, so and now let's get into the like what are the questions asked. First, the duration of interview was around 20 to 25 minutes roughly. It was approximately the same as the time which they said. They said it would be for 20 minutes, 19 minutes, and it was approximately for that time. And the interviewer came just 1 or 2 minutes late, I guess. That's not late actually, because they will be organizing continuous meetings and they have to see your profile and all, right? So the interviewer came on time, and the first thing he asked me to show my ID proof. I showed him my college ID card. So you can show any of your ID proof to the interviewer as a proof, okay? And then he asked you to introduce about yourself. He asked me to introduce about myself. I said about myself, and from the points which I told about myself, he again asked some questions. Like I told about my YouTube channel, and he asked me, what's your motivation to start your YouTube channel, and from where do you get the content and all those things he asked me. And then I did not mention anything about my family when I was introducing about myself. So then he separately asked me about my family, and he also asked me, what are your strengths and weakness. When you're answering this question about what are your strengths and weakness, make sure that you will give your genuine answer, because if you say something as your strength, then he may ask you again questions from that, and if you say something as your weakness, he may ask you to justify why that is your weakness. So be very genuine with the interviewer, right? You need not impress him. And what's your aim in future? So what do you want to become in future? And that is what he asked, and I said, I just want to settle in a good job and all, that is what I said. And he asked me about my project. This took a lot of time in the interview. Since in our college we are actually done only with the mini project. So I just explained him about the mini project, and he asked so many questions from that. And he asked me first, I just randomly told whatever I know about my project. Then he said, not in this way, you have to tell what is the title, what are the technologies that you are involving in that, and what is the description, what is its main purpose of the project, and how technologies are related to the project, and in which stage your project is, whether you've developed any prototype. So he said you have to tell all these things, and then I said all these things in the order which he asked. So that is what about project happened. And he also asked me some questions like, what is the use of this project? Do you think this kind of project already exists? And that were the questions he asked me. And then, after that he said, since we deal with clients abroad and all, so you may have to work in different shifts, and are you comfortable with that? He asked me in odd timings. What is that he made sure was, you'll be working only for 9 hours a day, but a shift may depend, maybe in the night or maybe in the midnight or maybe early in the morning. So shift, he asked me about, are you willing to work in different shifts? And he also asked me about relocation, all over the country, anywhere over the country, are you willing to work? He asked me about the relocation. And he also asked me about my He also asked me about how are your classes going during this COVID period, online classes, how are you able to understand classes and exams. Like I said, classes are going online and some of the exams you are supposed to go and write in the college and all, I said, and he asked whether you're able to understand the things or not. Like that, some questions. And he also asked me, what do you think is very important for an interview? Since I said I make videos on YouTube, that is the reason why he asked. Maybe I am thinking that. Generally, he may not ask others. But still, he asked me, what do you think is very important for an interview and all. And if suddenly this meeting is disconnected, then what would you do is what he asked. And later, after answering the question, the answer I gave was, I'll be waiting for some time, and then even though if it does not connect, I'll be writing a mail to the talent acquisition, from which I got Infosys meeting ID and all. Then he said that's good, and you also first thing that you have to do is you have to check whether the problem is from your side or from my side. You have to check that first is what he said. Like he also said that I'm asking you this question to test your presence of mind, how do you react to situations and all. And he asked me, do you have any doubts or questions? And he also asked me, do you know for which role you're being interviewed? So this is what he asked me. Then I said, for system engineer role and all. So in the last, he asked me, do you have any doubts or questions? Before that, let me tell you what were the technical questions that were asked to me. So technical questions, very less questions, very few questions. He asked me, what is the use of header file in C? And then I said, what is the use of header files? And I also gave some examples of header files, like why we use standard stdio, why we use conio. He asked me to give some more examples. Then I said about string. Then I said about standard library, math, all those, like whatever the header functions I know, I told him about all those things. And he also asked me, what is a pointer and what is an array and what is the difference between pointer and array. He also, like, you have to tell everything, like I said everything, like pointers we use for address, for location, star, and arrays, about the definition of arrays and indexes, why we use index, how do we access the array elements and all those things I said. And last, he asked me, do you have any questions or doubts? Then I said no. Then the interview was done, that's all. The interview went in a very friendly way. Seriously, you need not feel nervous about the interview. Be confident and make sure that you improve your communication skills a lot. See, everybody are good at speaking. If we are asked to speak in our mother tongue, most of us will speak fluently. Most of us will speak happily without any hesitation or without any fear. But it comes to the point where you have to speak in English if you're not perfect in English. Everybody of us know English since we are from English medium, of course. But we may not be able to speak fluently since we lost practice of speaking in English. So start speaking in English if you really want to get job into a company, if you really want to crack an interview, because your confidence is what they see the most. Your confidence, you can build up your confidence only when you are perfect about the language. So make sure, and also dress up in a formal attire. And also be ready with your ID card and any of the ID proof. It's not like after the interviewer comes and sits, then you'll show your ID card and then you will get up from your place for your ID card and all. Don't do all that things. And also make sure that your the room in which you're sitting is properly lit. Light is, you know, no shadows, no reflections and all. No, you know, blurred images and all. Make sure that your attire, your costume, your hairstyle, everything is important. So be careful when you're attending an interview. And all the best for your interview. If you're still having any doubts, let me know in the comment section. I'll definitely try to clear your doubts for sure. But since the technical questions which were asked to me were very less and very, you know, were from a very basic, so don't think that you may be also asked the same questions. So just prepare, some basic from all the topics like SQL, Java, OOPS, C++ and all. I made a series of videos about the questions, the Infosys interview questions, and you can have a look at those questions. And that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for your patience towards the video. If you're still having any doubts, any clarifications, feel free to comment it down. I'll definitely reach out to you guys. Thank you for watching my video.